Good day. Good day to you. I am a very intriguing and erudite man from the control room of the BBC's Bush House, London. I would like to tell you about an exciting new development in the teaching of English. From the people who brought you English by Carrier Pigeon, English by Radio, or Wireless, as we young hipsters like to call it. Let's have a listen.
English by Radio.
Now, are you familiar with such things as prepositions?
Prepositions. A preposition is a word composed of position and pre, which means before.
Using the radio to teach English is just the beginning. The future is far more exciting. The television.
In the first program in this series, we looked at one thing we mean when we talk about good speech. Accent, remember?
Advancements in science will mean people will no longer have to smoke to stay healthy. They will be able to use medicine instead. That's why experts predict English by injection will become popular. Experts inform us that by the 1970s and 80s, even poor people will own and drive a car. And that's why English for driving will become necessary.
In L Driver, I'll help you to understand the English you'll hear when you're learning to drive.
In the space age, the BBC will employ a furry alien called Muzzy to teach English. It's dangerous out in space. It can also be dangerous here on Earth. That's why the BBC will help people to learn English for emergencies.
Oh my God, Maria, I've left a pan of chips on the stove.
The door slammed and she's locked
out. There's a pan of chips on the stove in there. There'll be a fire.
By the way, love.
Let me finish this trip into the future with the most exciting idea of them all. The computer. But not just that. Computers all around the world joined to each other by something called an interweb. People will be able to learn English on one of these machines. An interweb. Imagine that! Hang on. I appear to be in the internet. Help! Somebody! Ah! Help me! I'm trapped in the internet! Ah!